I think everybody has had a little bit of fear of stepping in front of the camera. Sometimes it's just normal to just jump in front of the camera. Hey, I'm here. I don't know about you, but when I was 7 years old, when my dad bought us the first camcorder, you know, my brother was born, it was all about the baby brother. Like, hey, you got to film the baby brother. And I'd like jump in front of the camera and I'd be like, hey, and they're like, Tamara, get out of the way, get out of the way. You know, we want to film your baby brother. You know, I was about 7 years old and I was like, you know, but since then I've always been like kind of a ham jumping in front of the camera. But you know, there's been points where yes, I've been fearful of coming on camera as well, because you want to be confident on camera, but there's so many things that can attribute to why you're not confident on camera, right? And so I'm going to talk about a few of those things that I've seen from our clients of having jumped past the fear and being confident on camera as well. So one of those things is a lot of people just don't know where to start, right? Like simply like just starting recording, getting in front of the camera, it actually allows you to become more comfortable doing so. And so once you get more practice, you know, it's not like practice makes perfect or anything like that, but you know, that's another point to it, is another thing that comes up is actually perfection, right? So if I'm over here worrying about every little piece that, you know, could go wrong, like, oh, you know, I messed up, or I said, or, you know, my hair is sticking up or whatnot. Like, I can't think of being a perfectionist. I'm going to produce something the best that I can and put it out there and be confident in doing so, because the more you put yourself out there, the more people can see you, find you, and see you as the authority as well in your niche. Another thing that's really important is really figuring out, like, what is the right messaging that you're putting out there, because if you're not confident in your messaging, then you know it's going to allow you to feel a little bit more uncomfortable on camera, right? Because when you have the right messaging, it's going to come across on the camera the right way, because you're the expert in your niche. And that also allows people to connect with you. Are you inspiring? Are you witty? Are you fun? Are you charismatic? Whatever that looks like, you know, add that into your messaging with yourself too, so you're not robotic, right? And so on that piece, having the messaging right, then you're able to actually come together and, you know, become more confident on camera with that as well. You know, another thing is people, they don't know how to position themselves well as the authority. Like, positioning it is a key point of your own business, especially if you're a coach, consultant, entrepreneur, influencer. It's all about positioning, because the way that people perceive you on camera and from the stage, or if you get, let's say you get invited to be on a TV show, like the news station or whatnot, those are all things that attribute on camera to positioning, right? Because you are the authority, you're there to share, and you have this, you know, maybe you have a professional setup, maybe you're just using your webcam, maybe you're using your iPhone, maybe, but you just need to get started really to be able to become more confident on camera. Another thing that gets caught up in the mix is what we call imposter syndrome, right? So imposter syndrome, people get this fear that, you know, they'll put themselves out there on camera and then, you know, somebody might, you know, judge them for something, or, you know, you don't feel like you did good enough to explain something that you already know and that you've learned for years. You are the expert. So being able to step in there, share your value, share your expertise, that is enough. You are just you. You are doing what you do. You do what you do best in your niche. And when you're passionate about it, it comes through on camera, as well as pertaining to the confidence piece of being confident on camera and passionate about what you do. I think one of the excuses that people make that also could pertain to the overall essence of being confident on camera is an excuse they make is the lack of time to produce, you know, a well quality, you know, video or whatnot. Like I said, you don't have to start off with professional gear or anything like that as you get going, but the more you actually produce content, you will actually get more comfortable and confident at it. But people will make up excuses that they don't have enough time to do so, which I would say BS. You know, that's BS. Everybody has time to create content. You literally just have to put it on your calendar if you're somebody that has to schedule it out so you know when you need to shoot content. If you recorded and released one YouTube video a week, you know, let's say they were an average of 10 minutes a piece. That's 40 minutes out of your entire month. You can batch record them and become more confident because you're starting to flow more, right? So, you know, and when, by doing that batching content, you know, you're using up your time wisely and you're becoming more confident and comfortable on camera by just recording those content back to back. Maybe you're not tech savvy. We have a lot of clients that we work with that are like, oh my gosh, Tamara, I'm not sure how to use my iPhone effectively. Do I need to have it landscape, you know, or do is it horizontal or vertical? You know, like for YouTube, you definitely want it to be, you know, horizontal so that you actually can fill the screen for the videos, right? But then you got like TikTok and you've got Instagram and Facebook stories and you have it vertical, right? So that when people are going through their feeds on Facebook too, it fills your screen, right? So there's different ways to actually create content, and you don't have to be super tech savvy because you're just using your smartphone. Simply, you know, check your camera settings, check if it's in HD, high definition, and also check the exposure lock on your iPhone. There's also set settings on your Androids and whatnot as well, but you don't have to be super tech savvy to just get started. That's my whole thing, is you don't need this whole big setup with two cameras or lights or a microphone to get going. But you know, I do recommend that you think about upgrading throughout your experience so your videos can pop, they can become more professional as well. But that really isn't the piece that I'm making here, is you do not have to start out with professional gear to be camera confident, basically. Another thing is, a lot of people have this question, am I camera ready? Am I wearing the right thing? You know, like that's probably everybody's question. Like, am I ready? Are we ever ready to step in front of a camera? You know, are we ever ready to jump out of a plane and go skydiving? You know, are we ever ready to go like jump in a cage with the sharks? I'm not. So I don't know. I think jumping in front of a camera is a lot easier than those two that I just projected. So on that point, you know, am I camera ready? You know, you can go through a checklist and really think about it. Like, am I wearing a solid color? Am I wearing something that, you know, doesn't really take away from a busyness on my shirt so that they can really focus on what I'm saying? Like, you know, things like that. Like, you really got to think about, am I camera ready? Yes. And I have actually other tools that I can share with you that you can look up to actually know what to wear on camera, and also check out another video that I'll be shooting as well for you guys. I think the last thing that people really worry about is when they're wanting to be comfortable on camera, they want to be confident on camera, and then when they actually do, they put themselves out there and they're like, yes, I did it, and then all of a sudden your social media is like crickets. And so in that point, your social media is like crickets, but you have to be proud of yourself for actually posting a video, posting content, and actually putting yourself out there. Because the more you do that, the more that you're consistent, the more you become more confident in that space, you know, of recording more videos. And when you show up consistently for your clients, for your audience, for your YouTube subscribers, the more that you show up, the more confident you become, because more people will start following you. And that's really what it's about, is consistently showing up and being able to just get started and utilize all those things. Think about those things that I just shared with you in this video. Honestly, it's really truly in your mind. It's all about mindset. We should call this camera confidence mindset, right? Because at that point, all the little technical things don't really matter. It's about you putting yourself out there, you becoming more confident in yourself, and all the rest comes to it through that experience as well. So if you like this video and you want to see more, be sure to subscribe and ring the bell icon so that you can receive weekly notifications. I'll see you next time.